this week I want to go transition from that into the cell phone data, and I like to show this graph because in 2008 it was mind-blowing that we might be able to look at everybody's cell phone and figure out where the bad guy was or what people are doing. Here, Batman used cell phone data to find the Joker and basically save the day. Now here, we're gonna be using cell phone data to try to help inform us about what's happening in the community. And this data that we're obtaining, it's freely available to people in commerce. And so if you downloaded that app and you clicked yes, let you track my GPS, that could be where some of this data is coming from. I'm sure I have it on my phone, as most of you have software like that on your phones. And the reason why I'm going to this now is we want to know, well, what's behind the acceleration in the number of cases in the Coastal Bend area right now? We know that there's more testing, but something that we also know is that there's more activity going on. And just to explain what's going on here for those who haven't seen this again, what we have here is an encounter index. And we've scaled this encounter index to the Coastal Bend area, and this is explicitly Nueces County. And we made it so that the average amount of contacts that were detectable by a cell phone, and by contact or encounter, what we mean is the probability of two people making contact and the overall probability of that happening per kilometer squared per day in Nueces County. The way this works at a smaller scale is, say two devices come within 60 meters of each other, it triggers a statistical algorithm that calculates the probability that those two phones will actually come within 6 feet of each other. We can't know for sure whether they do or they don't. It's dependent upon that algorithm that estimates that probability. But suffice to say, the longer two cell phones are within a proximity of each other, the higher the probability is that they'll come in contact with each other. That's kind of how this works. Basically, high means normal activity. 100 means that's what we were doing before we realized that COVID-19 was really here in the U.S. and was really a threat to us here in the Coastal Bend. And that's what's represented by that line. That's March 9th, which was the first day of spring break for TAMU-CC and 2 days before the NBA canceled its games, at least for the foreseeable future. From that point forward, you can see that there was a precipitous decline in this index, which is based upon cell phone encounters and how close they're coming together. So by the time we got to the stay-at-home order, we were already at a low point in the amount of encounters that were happening, according to this index in Nueces County. But what I want to draw your attention to is right over here, right at the lower point, somewhere between April 7th and April 13th. This is Easter, by the way, that low point there, to calibrate you. That's where our vigilance kind of waned, and we started to get cabin fever. And despite the same orders being in place, we here in Nueces County started to behave a little bit differently. We maybe went out a little bit more than we did for the first 2 weeks of the stay-at-home. And that's what you're seeing here in the increase in these numbers. Now, last week, we were kind of over. And now, this week, not as steep of an incline, which makes me feel better, being, you know, living in Nueces County. But at the same time, it still has a slightly upward trend. And there is a definite phenomenon that there were potentially more transmissions between people going from the middle of the stay-at-home to the end of the stay-at-home before the stay-at-home was even lifted. That's one of the reasons why we started looking at this data, because this is the first indication that we'll have that there might be an increase in the number of cases.